Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released an all-new type of update, iOS Security Response 16.2a. Now this is currently available for beta testers, so if you're on iOS 16.2 Developer Beta 3 or iOS 16.2 Public Beta 3, you'll see this update now. And this is a new type of update Apple talked about with the introduction of iOS 16 that allows them to rapidly update the phone with security updates and bug fixes. And so you can see this is the first of its kind, and it came in at 96 megabytes on the 14 Pro Max. It was a little bit bigger on the iPad, and I'll show you the install overall process as it's a little bit different and much faster than before. Now, as you can see, it says this rapid security response provides important security fixes and is recommended for all users. And the link that they're actually providing brings you directly to the Apple Security Updates webpage. However, there's no information about it. Now you can see they also released tvOS 16.1.1 today, and that was just to fix an app installation bug. However, this is the first time we've seen a security response update. So they're testing it with beta testers, and now we'll be able to test that out, try it out, and we'll take a look at the build number as some things have changed there as well. Now, I wanted to show you how you install this because it's a little bit different as far as its overall speed. If we go into settings, you'll see I have it here on the iPad and it's downloaded. It was a little over 100 megabytes. We'll hit install now. I'll put in my passcode. Now it says verifying security response. We'll give it just a moment and it should reboot in just a moment and be done. It took under a minute for my iPhone to install this update. So we'll give it a moment, see if it reboots quickly. You'll see it's rebooting the iPad right away. We'll give it just a moment. And that was pretty much it. It was just about done as soon as it rebooted. So let's give it a second here and see what happens. So hopefully it's pretty quick. We're back up. Let's see if we can unlock here. We unlocked and that's it. It's installed already. That was in real time. I didn't pause the video or jump forward. It was extremely fast, and that's a rapid security response update. And so once you've installed the update, once you go to your software update page, it's a little bit different. You'll see this in software updates if you're wanting to install it. So you just go to software update. And I did find that on this phone, I had to go into my settings and turn on security responses and system files. It showed up, but it actually showed up on my other phone, my iPhone 14 Pro, without doing that. So it varies from device to device. However, now if we go to about, you can see the version number is 16.2A. So you would think we'd have a new build number. Now you'll see the build. We have two separate ones. We have the main iOS build number and then the new rapid security response build number. So we have a very long 16.2A and then 20C7750490E. And so this is something new. We can even remove the security response. Now, whether or not we'll be able to do that in the future is hard to say, as Apple could change this up, just make it installed and not be able to remove it. But during the beta test, at least we'll be able to remove that if it's causing any issues. But it should include bug fixes and improvements. Now, what specifically those are, Apple hasn't said. There's not a whole lot of information about that. So we'll have to wait and see if it improves anything, but the phone wasn't even hot when it rebooted, and I wouldn't expect any difference as far as performance or anything else. They're probably just testing out a feature to see how well it will install and how quickly. So you saw how fast it installed. That was pretty impressive. And so what this will do is just give us the ability to not have major updates. In fact, in some cases where we'll have a small update, maybe an iOS 16.0.1 to fix something, now they can just push a security response update, patch a security hole, fix some bugs, and then be done with it. Then when they want to add features, they can push those with iOS 16.2 or larger point updates, 16.2, 16.3, and so on. But I wouldn't expect this to affect performance or battery life unless there was a bug. If they had a memory leak or some app was using additional background activity and it wasn't supposed to, that could certainly increase battery life overall. So it's great to have these faster responses. And this could be a response to what we had with Apple the other day, where they said the feedback system through Apple, with an email from Craig Federighi that was mentioned on Mac Rumors. I mentioned it in yesterday's video as well. Maybe this is just the start of that, where they'll have better feedback. They can rapidly patch that issue, push it to iPhones, and then work on more solid features over time, such as Freeform, instead of having to wait years or months for it to actually release. Now, if you've already installed the iOS Security Response 16.2 and you found something else I didn't mention, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And also, what do you think about these security response updates? I think it's a great idea, but I'd love to hear from you there as well. I like that we have the ability to install it on our own or not install it, just like a normal update. But let me know what you think in the comments below. Of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.